I'm a senior in history and literature studying post-colonial studies. I'm from South Africa and tried for a very long time in history and literature department not to study South Africa. And gave into the inevitable halfway through my junior year. And this summer I had the opportunity to go back to Johannesburg, where I'm from, and this time actually research home, which was a very interesting experience. I think I found it very exciting just to go and lose myself in libraries. And quite literally losing myself in a library did result in one of the biggest finds of my history lit career, I think. I was stuck down in this dingy, dark, and very dull library. And in my wanderings in the library, I came across this neat row of small magazines. They turned out to be this literary magazine, which had been started in the 60s. It was started by this man over here, Nat Nakasa. He was, in fact, a Nieman fellow at Harvard in the 1960s. The first story I read in the classic was actually about him. Unfortunately, it was a very tragic story, and it detailed his death when he committed suicide in New York. And that was a rather interesting place to start in my journey with the classic, starting with the ending of The Founder. But I think in some ways it drew me into the narrative of this magazine's story. It showed me the depth of humanity that could be found within its pages. And I'm going to read a little bit from the editor's note. Nat Nakasa, the founding editor of The Classic, was born in Durban. The major part of his adult working life was spent as a journalist in Johannesburg. He wrote chiefly for The Drum, The Gold City Post, and The Rand Daily Mail. In 1964, he was granted a Nieman scholarship for study at Harvard University, but his passport was withheld. He left South Africa toward the end of 1964 on an exit permit, which prohibited his return to this country. He was 28 years old when he died on the 14th of July, 1965, after a fall from the seventh story of a building in New York. In the edition I picked up, The World of Nat Nakasa, Nadine Gordimer, one of South Africa's greatest literary figures, writes about Nat, saying, "Nat was gone. He never came back. But he was the beginning, not the end of something. In so many ways, he was starting where others left off. When I opened my first edition of The Classic and read about Nat Nakasa's story, that's what I felt. I felt like I was beginning a journey, an incredible journey, looking at the pages of this small literary magazine and discovering something for myself."